The U.S. has topped 1 million confirmed cases of coronavirus on Tuesday, close to a third of the cases worldwide. This as more states across the U.S. are lifting restrictions this week. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention has submitted to the White House detailed guidelines on how offices can bring back employees, how restaurants can serve dine-in customers, how churches can welcome their faithful, and how schools can start teaching kids in classrooms again. Churches are being advised to continue holding services online or at least have them in drive-in and outdoor venues. If they're opening their doors to parishioners, they are cautioned to stagger schedules of services and make sure pews are not packed with churchgoers, wearing masks and staying 6 feet apart. When schools do reopen, experts said students' tables have to be 6 feet apart, and they should be allowed to take their meals in the classrooms while cafeterias, gyms, and other common areas of congregation remain closed. Restaurants, on the other hand, are advised to provide one-time use disposable menus, have tables 6 feet apart, use disposable utensils and plates, and limit the number of employees per shift. Fiberglass covers at takeout counters called sneeze guards have to be installed as well. Representatives from the restaurant industry said the new guidelines address many health and sanitation issues that are already covered by the food code, but that they also expect restaurant owners to welcome the guidelines.
The key part is just making sure that the public understands that restaurateurs are serious. They want people to come back in and dine when they're given the okay and when they feel that they're ready. And they're absolutely serious about making sure that the public is safe. They know they can create the right kinds of meals. Now it's making sure that the public can feel comfortable coming back in and dining again.
Many beaches have also reopened, along with more restrictions easing in public places.
We've seen masks. I mean, we also have ours here too, so we're always prepared and safe. But honestly, everybody's been keeping their distance, which is pretty cool, as have we.
As Georgia, Alaska, South Carolina, and Oklahoma began reopening their businesses last week, this week Colorado, Mississippi, Minnesota, Montana, and Tennessee are following suit. This as health experts warn that opening too early could cause a second wave of outbreaks that may be difficult to contain. Meanwhile, President Donald Trump on Monday claimed that more testing are available and should be at sufficient levels to support reopening efforts across the country.
We are continuing to rapidly expand our capacity and confident that we have enough testing to begin reopening and the reopening process. We want to get our country open, and the testing is not going to be a problem at all. In fact, it's going to be one of the great assets that we have.
DJ Manotok, ABS-CBN News.
As they develop their plans for phase